This is The Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Senate Republican Caucus. I'm Tracy Ellis. The Senate Republican budget leader has a warning for taxpayers after the state Supreme Court backed the capital gains income tax. Senator Linda Wilson says the court's ruling that the tax adopted by Democrats is constitutional is disappointing.
I don't know how they came to this conclusion because all the other states in the union and the IRS call this taxable income.
Income taxes are illegal in Washington. She says Democrats were hoping the court would rule in a way that would enable them to try for a full-blown income tax.
They didn't change the long-standing ruling that income is property. That is what they were hoping that would happen. So that would have given them the ability to go in to create a full-blown income tax.
While she doesn't see how this decision could lead to an income tax, Wilson says taxpayers clearly need to be on their guard.
Somehow down the line, they might try to figure out how to do this, but at least right now, they can't. But we need to be vigilant in watching what they are doing.
She expects the Democrats to start adjusting the parameters of the tax so it applies to more and more people over time.
Like the wealth tax, they've already reduced that from the billionaire to the 250 millionaire. Of course, we always are concerned about how they might change it.
Meanwhile, Wilson says there is some positive news. No new taxes and investments in things like public safety and education have her and some other Republicans actually applauding a proposed state budget from Senate Democrats. Wilson says she appreciates the smaller than normal spending increase, just 8%.
Where the average over the course of the last few years have been average about 19%.
And most importantly,
no new taxes, at least in this side, on the Senate side.
She hopes the House follows suit. Republican Senator Chris Gildon says highlights of the $69 billion spending plan include money to address learning loss, the nursing shortage, and low Medicaid reimbursement rates.
I think pretty much everyone can find something that they don't like, and they can find something that they do like. But you're going to see Republican priorities peppered all throughout the budget.
Senate Republican Leader John Braun agrees.
Public safety, it does fund the regional criminal justice training centers, which is an important part of rebuilding our law enforcement community around the state. When it comes to affordability, I think the most important thing is there's no new taxes. That's a big move. We don't need new taxes based on revenue growth. And then when it comes to education, I think this is the most important thing. Significant funding for intensive tutoring, for additional instruction for summer school, for school districts across the state to help our students get back on track and give them the education they deserve. It also includes significant funding for special education students, a thing that we've been working on for years here in the Senate, and I'm glad to see it finally make it into the budget.
Wilson appreciates the collaborative approach Democrats took to writing the budget.
I really appreciated being at the table, start to finish, and some of the important things that we advocated for got in.
The Senate and House will need to negotiate a final budget by the end of the legislative session. The Elephant in the Dome is the official podcast of the Senate Republican Caucus. I'm Tracy Ellis.